In the previous section, I pay attention more on the customer role in this ecopreneurship, that the customer awareness, environmental awareness can force companies to do business more eco-friendly and to change their technologies, to change the way they produce goods and services. But not only customers have to push the business to this environmental side, also it can come from the company itself. So the company can feel this social response. And it's also the social response is also connected with the environment, because as I said at the beginning of my lecture, those two aims of sustainable development are very much related, because any damaged, any making the environment lower, the environment conditions worst, it directly influences the conditions of, and the quality of life, of people's life. Especially it can be observed in the urban areas, but not only, because in the total, the less quality of environment means less quality of life for the population, of course. So that's very, very connected, those two aims. And this company social response or corporation's social response, that's the management strategy according to which companies voluntarily take into account social interest, environmental aspects, and relations with various groups of stakeholders, in particular with employees. That means that that's the from the entrepreneur side to make to drive his own business according to those rules. And of course, because it's voluntarily, and there is no like this company social response, it's not the regulations, it's not based on the law. It's only the set of main areas or tasks which are related with this social response. And those companies who like to be seen like a social response, they try to deal with those areas, try to keep those tasks be done perfectly. So the first of all, the human rights, the fair market practices. So that's in relation to the customers, but also to other stakeholders, like other companies, with them, which they are corporate, for example, suppliers and so on. Next, the protection of the natural environment. So that's mean in every aspect, in the production, but also in the settle, the plant and so on, with the disposal of waste, or try to operate like with this idea of zero of less waste. Protection of the customer rights, and all this area with proper employment practices, that's very important, and also every practices which are anti-corruption. So those main areas and tasks are very important from the social point of view, but that's not the regulation. So the companies are not forced by law to keep it. Of course, many of those aspects, like those tasks, like for example, human rights, are related by the national and international laws. but and also environmental issues are regulated. But we know that those companies which are somehow hard for the environment and society, they tried to avoid the rights. Yes, they tried to operate to not keep the regulations, the law regulations. So that's the problem. And because this idea is voluntarily taken by the companies, so nobody can have this like proof that okay, this company, we for example welcome this company to our area, we allowed it to invest here, but we don't know this company will be good for our society and for our environment. So it's only based on trust. If the company put this management strategy and show it in their aim, in their mission, that they try to operate according to those areas, according to those tasks, we can only trust them. So that's the weak point of this, but it's very important. Because the social response is also connected with those customer expectations. When the company knows that they are together, that the customers expect to keep those environmental awareness, and companies try to do it, everything together works very well. But of course, this part, like with this customer awareness, that needs education, first of all. So, because from the customer point of view, the most important during the buying decision is the less cost. So the less price, the better. From the company's point of view, which try to gain the as much profit as is possible, the less costs, the better. Yes. So first of all, it's like root grass work. So the education about the environment, educations about those relations, how our consumption and how our production influence the environment and the quality of life in future. Okay, so to sum up everything I said during this lecture, I would like to put this definition once again. So the environmental economics is focused on the efficient allocation on environmental and natural resources. And this environmental economics studies the economic and environmental effects of politics. Of course, those politics connected with the environmental issues and also social issues, because as I said, it's very related, and together we have to treat them together. So the main problem and aspects and studies, researches and awareness of this environmental economics is about how to push economy and entrepreneurship to sustainability. And those two ways, two tools, yes, or a kind of solutions are based on, first of all, regulations. This way to gain those environmental and social aims is very fast, because we can, for example, by regulation, we can prohibit some behavior. We can prohibit to operate some company in our area, or we can prohibit to sell some kind of products. Of course, it's very quick and quite easy to do, but unfortunately, every regulation on the market make the market less effective. Every regulation is kind of disruption for the market. So too much regulations, too much taxes, or for example, funding, like with the, for example, with the electric car, extra funding for the customer side. So the customer have the less price and the company get the price needed. That makes the market mechanism less effective because company cannot feel that they need to improve the technology, for example. Because if the client don't have to pay this huge price, for the company, there is no any push, yes, any reason why they should invest to develop the better technology. So somehow regulations make that the resources are less effective less effective use than it could be. But of course, those solutions are very fast. And somehow, at the beginning, they are very important to stop some the worst behavior at the market and in the environment. But the second set of the solutions, those are based on the customer expectations. So when so on the market mechanism is like it's based on the demand. So when the as long as only demand rules on the market without regulations, when the customer expect that companies will operate only in environment friendly way, they can force every right behavior of the company. But customers have to be aware awareness about this and very and like they have to check if the company really operate in eco-friendly manner. So they have to be very aware and check how it that it's produced. Is really company right what they say, for example? Is it true? Yes, is it really worth to trust and so on? And that's already some populations, some nations already gain this level of customer expectations, but that needs like even two generations of the education. So education about this environmental issues and relation between the environment and social life is the most important because when we have, because also like for example, students will be the businessmen also, not only customers. And those businessmen which will be aware about the environmental issues, they will be a social response in their business, yes? And also like the customers, they will push a business to be more eco-friendly. Okay, that, those are all what I wanted to say in this aspects in this topic about the economics related with the environmental issues in the macro level and micro level. So thank you for your attention. Thank you.